Working from the gun, Rodgers. Pass incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver. And it's second down. To throw again, Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And it goes for a gain of 31.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. And he's had great protection back there to throw, really been able to survey from the pocket.
That means the jersey stays clean, so the dry cleaning bill, that's reduced. It also means the trainer doesn't have to deal with him because he's not getting hit. Also means that he's able to find targets downfield at his leisure. That allows him to be really accurate.
And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good, but a flag is down here, so hold on. Let's see what this is about. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And this one is right down the middle. And they jump back in front here. It's 9-7. So he splits the uprights, and has to be a nice feeling. Right when it left his foot, knew it was good.
Yeah, just like a good three-point shooter in basketball, right? Release the ball, fall back on defense without even looking. You know it's going in the hoop.
They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. Well, unfortunately, unable to achieve the results you're looking for, but there's always next time. And now the offense getting set, first and 10. On first down, it's Freeman. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. From the gun, it's a run for Freeman. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that. And Freeman lost the football. And this is going to be Packer football.
The psychology.
That's great.
And the offense readies for a first down and 10. They'll run on first down. It's Brown. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Let's talk about football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
15 yards on the play, first down. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. The first round pick, Jair Alexander, making the tackle on second down now. It's Brown. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Za'Darius Smith able to get him down. Well, he is marked down right about on top of that imaginary yellow line, but they say he's a bit short. The ball's still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and run for it with Brown. And a great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps them pick up the first. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. Now it's Brown. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. An effective 10 yards there takes us back to first down. The impressive opening drive continues and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
Now another timeout called for by the offense. The 13th play now coming on this opening drive. Here's third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Bit of a surprise they ran it on third and medium. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
Wow.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
This is Fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 26. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones.
That's it, baby.
Four quarters not enough. We're all even and to overtime we go. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
This is taken at his 4. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line.
Here we go.
The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. Now a first down carry by Jones. Tackle made by K'Wan Short.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
On second down, it's Jones. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. minus 9 yards on the play, and now it's third down.
It'd be real interesting to take a look at this play later, because on this pitch toss play, I get the sense that he just followed the pulling guard or the pulling offensive lineman through that hole.
And he's in the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner in OT. Yeah, too bad. Can't win them all, though. Come back. Try again. Thanks for playing the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. And the Ultimates, their offense gets ready. First down and 10.
Here we go.
On first down, Brown. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Right back to him on first down. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that.
A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 27 yards there, a first down. Boy, the offensive line there, that was a thing of beauty to watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front, and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point by them. The timing on point. The run even better.
On second down, it's Freeman. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
AOR 33.
On second down now, it's Brown, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown run, and his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive, and how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
Elliott Good on the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
And now the drive starts with a completion out to the right. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. So that does it. Put this one in the books. A successful Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. See you next time. You saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's Solo Challenge, Madden Ultimate Team. Go earn your keep. The Bills offense ready to go here on 1st and 10. On first down, Allen. On the left side, he finds Beasley. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, you should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Allen's throw is complete. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Back to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Tyler Croft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to. Oh, I know it goes against the grain here. It totally goes against it, but you've got to drop the ball in that situation. He makes a catch, but he loses yards and doesn't get out of bounds.
So this defense, they looked a little shaky to start the drive, but bottom line, they're a play away from finishing it off.
They rocked them a little bit on this drive, didn't they? But as you and I both know, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. They have a chance to end it right here.
And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he'll bring this one back to the 29.
And that one? Oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted. I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair. Low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art. But maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. And that does it for this one. Pat yourself on the back. You just completed and dominated the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge.
Okay, 30,000 in the pocket, no change. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay, all my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay, so when I die, I ain't gonna be from old age. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it.
All right, it's Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You know the drill. Let's get right down to it. So it's first and 10 for the Bears on offense as they get ready to go. On first down, Trubisky. That's Cordero Patterson hauling it in. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down for the Bears.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Allen Robinson, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down. How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go. Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one, and none of them being done very confidently.
Truth be told, I've never played chess, and I know that I'm not smart enough to play chess. Guys like you with your IQ, you can pull that off. Back to throw. And that will be incomplete. So now it's fourth down and short. And whatever they do, run or pass it, they've got to pick up the first here.
Yeah, and you mentioned running it. That is still an option. But as you've also said, they've got to do it quickly and get back to the line of scrimmage.
And he is not going anywhere. They stop him for no gain. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. And someone must have been in this hot sun a little too long. They've got the punt team out there, and just to clarify, it is not fourth down. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. So now Trubisky and the Bears down 7-6. A minute 47 on the clock. Needing at least 40 yards, you'd have to think, to have a shot. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down. I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guys going downfield to catch the ball, they've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
So another big shot dodged there defensively. Now they're just one more incompletion away from salting away this victory. And I know this feeling. They're almost giddy, but they have to stay focused and locked in. They can make one big mistake and throw it all away.
They'll try and pick it up with Cohen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
They had to convert there on fourth down, and they ran the football. Major surprise, but they pick it up. Now they've got to really hurry.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. He's back to throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Trying to get it to Tariq Cohen out of the backfield. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And it's third down. And the blitz does come. Now Trubisky lost the football. It's going the other way. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
Here's Trubisky. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And you can almost feel Trubisky saying, let's get to the line and hurry up. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Cordero Patterson, the one he was hoping to get it to. But now it'll be third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now it's Trubisky. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. All right, nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from where I sit. Congratulations. Good job on this Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. So the challenge is laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. And now the offense getting set, first and 10.
Alert.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. To throw, Mayfield. And nearly picked off there. And it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down. trying to get their tight end involved finally. That's the first time that they've looked his way. He's kind of been a forgotten man in this offense. And he's into the end zone for the receiving touchdown. From 8 yards out, and his guys are able to make this a close game again.
It's never any fun, Brandon, when you're the defensive team and the first drive of the game, you give up a touchdown. The key is not to get down. Make those adjustments and come back for your next series with the intent of shutting them down.
The drive summary that time, 5 plays. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage. And hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Second down, Mayfield. He's got Njoku over the middle. And oh, he coughed it up. And this is picked up by the defense. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Here's 2nd and 10 now from about the 32. Going to the air again with Mayfield. Over the middle, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
That one good for 7 as this long drive continues and the chains move again.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains, because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. This will be caught inside the 10. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry, ball gets tipped in the air, because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
Here we go, 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. Here's Mayfield. Jordan Reed has it. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. They only got two, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it first and goal. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. This secondary as a unit, they've worked really well together in this one, especially late.
A lot of cohesiveness, a lot of communication, and some great athleticism. They're playing so well now, a nickname is sure to follow. They're going to have to name this whole unit soon.
Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal.
Bottom line, two-yard gain's just not going to cut it in this situation. You've got to move the ball downfield in order to have a chance.
Defense will give him that the rest of the way. This will be caught at about the six. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. First things first here, they got to pick up the first down.
And remember, it is fourth down, so they've got to pick up a completion here. Otherwise, this one's over.
This one through, and the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
Now Mayfield and the Browns. Down 10-9, 25 seconds remaining. And they need about 35 yards to get in range for a winner as they come up on first down. Field on play action, and that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Johnson, the intended target, that'll bring up second down. They go play action. Mayfield now a desperation throw deep downfield. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. He was trying to go back to Beckham there, and it's third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. And now the third down throw incomplete as well. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Mayfield to throw for it on fourth. He's going to let it fly. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. So instead of running, Mayfield's going to throw it here. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. Second and 10 now from the 27. Mayfield to throw. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 22. But he will not be able to bring it back. My goodness, what a bizarre ending. The kind of decision that could get a quarterback released before he gets back to the locker room. But fortunately for him and his crew, the ball game is over. Nice job.
How many of y'all came to win?
Oh, they asked my name, huh?
You ready? STRO, I ain't come to play with you. Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you. It's early, I'm up. I can't spend the day with you. I'm minding my business. I ain't getting paid with you. I come look bright. I ain't finna play.
All right, the challenge is in front of you. Do you accept it? I hope so. Keep the game on. Play the challenge. It's Solo Challenge, Madden Ultimate Team. And the offense readies for a first down and 10. Play fake. Mayfield. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And all the way in for the touchdown. A big play there. 60 yards. And his guys have made this a one-score game now. Elliott Good with a PAT. And the lead down to 3 at 13-10. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken in.